मॉड्यूल 32 चीनी कोले प्रिंट मेकिंग। द टेक्निक इज ऑफन कंफ्यूज विद एनी काइंड ऑफ कोलाज वर्क्स विद एनी काइंड ऑफ कोलाज वर्क्स एंड इट शुड बी नोटेड दैट दिस टेक्निक और प्रोसेस इज वेरी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम कोलाज मेकिंग और डीकपेज। The Chini Kole printmaking technique is special as in the process. An image is transferred onto the surface that is bonded with a heavier support in the printing process. This allows the printing on a much more delicate surface, such as Japanese paper or linen, which pulls finer details of the plate used. The other purpose is quite unique as it provides a background color behind the image that is different from the surrounding backing sheet. It is safe to say that the final image depends upon the design and ink colors of the printed image. Also, the opacity and color of the paper used onto which the image is directly printed. One has to be note that inclusions such as fibers, papers, petals and leaves can be added to such kind of colored backing sheets. Time 2:15. Draw or trace a design or sketch on the block. This sketch can be further improved at the time of the final drawing of the block. Ideally, Chini Kole is a printmaking technique wherein papers of different colors or textures are adhered to the overall piece. The papers which are used to adhere could be pre-cut shapes bonded to the heavier support paper of the print in the process. The pieces are not simply glued to the print as a collage element. They are run through the printer machine ensuring they blend and fuse completely as one unit, unlike in collage making where the pieces are merely glued on the top of the other to create the work. The final output of Chini Kole work bonds the paper layers to simplify glue them together with the print. This may appear at some angles to be embossed. This would also be called as a direct print method and is fairly simple. Time 4. As this is a very versatile technique, it would be obvious that there are many methods of making Chini Kole prints. Most commonly used method includes the dampening of the thin paper and placing it on the inked plate. Once done, the whole plate with the thin paper is run through the press and the output assures a perfectly blended and bonded print to the paper. This would be the direct method where the dampening of papers used is very important as a printmaker has to control the expansion of the paper once wet and account for the shrinking of it after it goes dry. The other method is slightly different from the direct method in which the thin paper is dry and trimmed or cut to suit the design on the plate. Paste is then applied to the thin paper and allowed to dry. When the print is ready to be printed, the paper is dampened to activate the dry glue and placed gently on the specific place on the plate. This whole unit, inked plate plus thin plate with paste side facing up it is then placed on the dampening backing sheet and sent through a press. The advantage of the pre-pasted method is that once it dries, pasted thin papers are long-lasting and can be stored indefinitely, for example in the case of postage stamp. Care is taken about the expanding and contracting fibers of the papers for a good print. Time 6. The block could be prepared with the help of line etching, aquatint and other printmaking techniques. A traditionally made paper from the gampi fiber is used normally for Chini Kole prints. Some artists are known to experiment with non-traditional papers, sometimes newspapers, ephemera, dress patterns or book pages as additional onto the plate. There are a variety of adhesives used for chini kole printing. Some artists use a dusting of floor just before pressing rather than a paste. Some do not use adhesives and intend the high pressure of the printing presses of the printing press to merge the fibers, but this depends wholly on the type of paper used for the printing and is unreliable. Recent times have shown artists using PVC glue or gel mediums rather than a paste. Traditionally, rice or wheat paste was used as glue for chini kole. Gluten from these sources is at first removed from the hole, and then pure starch is made in distilled water making a silk sheaved gel. Starch based gels are considered as archival and used in many book related applications. So as we know, chini kole is a process of concurrently printing and mounting sheets of varying density to achieve a more sturdy ground for printing processes. It has to be taken to note that dampening of the paper also varies as far as chini kole is concerned. In some cases, mild dampening or even misting techniques are used. Techniques ensure that the papers are co-joined. Seamlessly, the chini kole technique is often paired with other printmaking techniques like lithograph, woodcut, linocut, monotype, etching. Example, Artist 1, Liz Myhill. Artist and printmaker Liz Myhill is from Scotland, and her works span a wide range of subject matters, usually influenced by direct working from life and nature. Her methods usually involve intensely length or spontaneous recordings undertaken during walking and watching in normal life. Although often at end in themselves, these field works are also developed into paintings and printmaking. Time 9:40. The block is now to be etched using a nitric acid solution. This is the etchant solution. Time 9:40. To prepare the etchant, mix carefully 1 part nitric acid with 8 parts water in a plastic tray, or 1:8 proportion of nitric acid, which has 60% purity. The backside of the block to be etched is first covered with an acid resistant coat, either of black Japan or plastic sticker. She hails from the Scottish Hebrides. And these islands and other wild places of Scottish Isles continue to inspire and provide a wealth of information and muses. However, pursuit of creative development and a sense of adventure have led to a number of expeditions further afield. Residencies have made the possibility of concentrated durations of travel and making new works, which continue to inform ongoing practice. Beginning close to home with a week-long residency on the Isle of Lewis in 2008, she has since worked in India, Cuba, Central America, and the US, sometimes for periods of several months on end. Liz has exhibited her works throughout the UK with regular shows at societies such as Royal Scottish Academy, Royal Scottish Society of Painters in Watercolour, and Royal Glasgow Institute of Fine Arts. She has been awarded the RGI David Cargill Award and the prestigious Elizabeth Greenshield Foundation Grant. She has also worked with master printers Ron Pocaraso and Lennox Dunbar and Don Messick at the Santa Fe, New Mexico residencies, acquiring a healthy exchange of techniques and knowledge from the big names of printmaking. While most of the works was monoprint or monotypes based, allowing for very painterly results and one-off images rather than multiples and additions. For Liz, it was a perfect way to expand the blurry areas on the margins of painting and printmaking, where the work is neither one thing or the other. In some of her works, based on Cuban drawings, she combines photo etch monotype, chine cole collage, and drawing to create the work of art. She at times also uses lots of colors, shapes, and textures down onto the paper before either working back into them to bring out a composition or cutting up to use as collage. As collages. Time 1340. Now carefully lower the etched block into the tray of the etching acid. The general proportion timing is for 25 minutes for the etched lines. Liz regularly works with a variety of printmaking techniques, one of her favorite being Colograph, taking some references about her inspirations of Sutherland. Of Sutherland, she had created plates with the intention of bringing together as much information bits she collected during her visit to that location. There are pieces or colograph which depict senses from marketplace of Gujarat in India. She finds a quiet spot to settle down and draws among the noise, hustle and bustle of the quadrangular shaped marketplace, with canopies and shades overhanging and the ambient crowds influx and outflow. What makes Liz Hill's works unique are their attention to details and the multiple employment of printmaking techniques, painting, drawing and collage work. This intense need to depict the scene as is often brings out the most depth of the otherwise mundane scenario. She also incorporates the dynamic weather and the play of light and shade which the Scottish Isles are known for. Time 1525. There is a possibility of air bubbles forming during the etching process. Hence, it is imperative one removes them using a feather or other such implement at the time the block is being etched. Example, Artist 2. Elizabeth Blackadder. Dame Elizabeth Blackadder is contemporary artist and printmaker born in Falkirk, Scotland on 24 September 1931. She studied at Edinburgh College of Art from 1949 to 1954 under the tutelage of Robert Haddleston Blyth and William Gillies and traveled on scholarships to Southern Europe and Italy. She was married to artist and fellow Scottish gallery exhibitor John Huston in 1956 and began teaching in Edinburgh. Deemed to be one of the Scotland's greatest artists, she also enjoys the recognition and success in London. She graduated in 1954 with first class degree and was awarded both a Carnegie Travelling Scholarship by the Royal Scottish Academy and an Andrew Grant Postgraduate Scholarship by Edinburgh College of Art. Time 18:05. Now to prepare the ink color to be used on the block, a few drops of black ink is poured onto the inking glass. Few drops of linseed oil is added to the ink. The ink and the oil is mixed on the inking glass. Now this ink is ready to use on the block. Elizabeth is best known for her detailed lyrical watercolors of flowers, tabletop compositions using oriental objects and her cats. Her trips to Japan and Venice and a greater emphasis on oil can be seen in landscape and townscape pieces as well as important still life series using decorated tins and boxes arranged with exotic fish, fruits and vegetables. Elizabeth is also known to be an inspiring and skillful printmaker, famous for her original and innovative prints. Original etchings by Elizabeth were so much the talk of the town that she was appointed Her Majesty's Painter and Limner in Scotland in 2001. Time 1710. Now a portion or form is chosen on the block, which is to be defined with the thinner, with a thin color tissue paper. Carefully cut the shape of the form as per the design chosen. She worked in variety of mediums from oil paintings, drawings to printmaking. At the Glasgow print studio, Elizabeth worked with several printmakers to produce etchings and screen prints of flowers. She often focuses on the space between subjects in her pictorial space, especially in her paintings or drawings. Her work can be seen at the Tate Gallery, the Scottish National Gallery of Modern Art, and the Museum of Modern Art in New York, and has appeared in a series of Royal Mail stamps. In 2012, Elizabeth was appointed to paint the Scottish First Minister Alex Salmond's official Christmas card. Elizabeth was the first woman to be an academician of both the Royal Academy of Arts in London and the Royal Scottish Academy. In 1982, she was awarded the OBE for her contributions to arts. This was later on promoted to DBE in 2003. She has been awarded several doctorates since 1989. Time 1950. Intaglio process employs the process of filling the ink in the block crevices and reliefs, and the edges and the surface is wiped off clean. She has been respected as a printmaker for over four decades, during which she has experimented with a range of diverse media, including lithography, dry point, woodcut, screen print, and chini colle. Elizabeth first experimented with printmaking during her student days in the early 1950s, and her first sets of prints were published in 1958. From then on, she has worked with a range of studios and publishers, including Curwen Studio, the Mercury Gallery, the Peacock Printers, and the Glasgow Print Studio. Her work is presented thematically, and this approach reveals her constant interest in still life composition and her interpretations of the natural world, from landscapes to animals. Dame Elizabeth Blackadder's works are included in the Tate Gallery collection, as well as in the Scottish National Gallery of Modern Art, among many other collections. She lives and works in Scotland. Time 2320. The thin cutout of colored tissues is placed on the plate in the design, with blue side facing upwards. The paper to be used to print is kept soaked and blotted half an hour before the print is taken, and should be damped with being printed for intaglio process. Time 2335. A final registration is made on the machine before the block is printed. Health and safety precautions. 1. Do not eat or drink close to work area to prevent accidental ingestion. 2. Familiarize yourself with substances that are hazardous. 3. Clean hands thoroughly after working using baby oil, soap and water, or a non-toxic hand cleaner. Keep work area clean and organized. 4. Keep work area clean and organized. 5. Ask your doctor if you are taking medication or are pregnant about what precautions you should be taking. 6. Identify locations of fire extinguishers, first aid box, and fire and eye wash stations. Ask your professor if need be. 7. Notify your professor about any health condition or medication that may affect you in the classroom. 8. Store concentrated nitric acid and potassium chloride separately from other chemicals. Whenever possible, use diluted acid. 9. Acid etching should be done with local exhaust ventilation. 10. An important safety rule when diluting concentrated acids is to add the acid to water, never the reverse. 11. Wear appropriate gloves, goggles, and protective apron or lab coat when handling acids. 12. If acid is spilled on your skin, wash with lots of water. In case of eye contact, rinse the eye with water for at least 15 to 20 minutes and seek medical attention. cover acid baths when not in use. 13. Oil-based inks contain treated linseed oils. While linseed oil is not considered a hazard by skin contact or inhalation, ingestion of large amount of some treated linseed oils might be hazardous due to presence of small amount of toxic heavy metals. Oil vehicles are flammable when heated, and rags soaked in these may ignite by spontaneous combustion. 14. Glues that are used are often safe and come with safety precautions on their labels. However, solvent or chemical glues should be carefully read about, or industrial glues should be first tested for hazardous effect on human skin and then cautiously used wearing mask and gloves. 15. In general, organic solvents are one of the most underrated hazards in the art materials. Organic solvents are used in printmaking to dissolve and mix with oils, resins, varnishes and inks, and to clean plates, rollers, tools, and even hands. 16. Keep tools sharp, store them safely, and always cut away from yourself. In advance, locate the nearest first aid box. 17. When possible, clamp down plates to avoid slippage. 18. Minimize the chance of carpal tunnel syndrome by choosing tools with wide handles, avoiding tight grips, and including hand flexing exercises during regular rest periods. Set work table height so wrist flexing motions are minimal. Time 24:20. The entire assembly is put through the printing machine very carefully. Time 24:25. Now take the final print on the final damp paper. Time 24:25. Mark the edition number on the paper. Time 24:55. Write all the details like date and signature on the print.